Hey everyone, just a quick word before we get started on this beer review. If you're interested in purchasing any of these beers that you see on my channel, stick around to the end of the video and I will tell you where you can purchase them at online. Now, isn't that lovely? Have beer shipped right to your home and don't have to go anywhere. All right, enjoy the video. Cheers to that. Welcome, my friends. Here we are once again to sample some more great tasting American craft beers with Dr. Dave. Fantastic, baby. Now for our sampling pleasures and tasting delights today. Oh, I think this is going to be quite lovely indeed. This is from the Alewerks Brewing Company. They're located in Williamsburg, Virginia, and this is the Tavern Brown Ale. Checks in at 5.7% alcohol by volume. I didn't see a date stamp on this. It's got a place for a date stamp, but it's blank. Boy, I don't know. What are we going to do with some of these brewers with these dates? Yeah, I'm not going to dwell on that. Let me open this very carefully because it's a bottle cap, and I love to collect bottle caps. The trick to not denting them is you have to center the bottle opener, which I like to use as corkscrew bottle opener, and just in one motion, just flip it right off. So yeah, this doesn't have any dents. That'll go. What I do is I put a magnet in here. I put some super glue in there, put the magnet in there, let it dry, and then put it on the fridge. And the reason I put super glue is on there is because if the refrigerator ever needs replaced, when you take these off, the magnet doesn't usually come with it. The bottle comes off, bottle cap comes off, and then the magnet sticks to the fridge. So this way, the whole unit comes off. I've gone through that before. That's why I know about this. We got this lovely gooseneck glassware that we just washed and rinsed. Oh, it's a lovely caramel color. Look at that. These types of beers usually build up a lot of head, so I've poured it quite gently, and now I'll go ahead and pour it straight in, and that way we should come up with some nice head, but we didn't quite make it, so what we'll do is we'll use our little stir stick, and we're going to make it look really nice for the camera. How about that? There you go. Made it look a little too nice, huh? Not to worry. That's why we keep all the necessary paper towels, and everything else in here. Not to worry at all. It's a very lovely autumn color. Yeah, that's it. Now on the camera, what you're looking at looks a lot darker than what I'm looking at. On the camera there, it looks more of a brownish with some caramel tint. This is definitely a caramel color. Oh, it's beautiful. A lovely tan-colored head. Oh, yeah. Now, of course, I had to stir it up. If I had been a little more aggressive with my pour, it would have naturally made a really nice-looking head. But I was kind of taking it easy because a lot of times with these brown ales, you go overboard. Oh, man, you'd be sorry. Now, I did taste this, a little bit of the foam there, and it's got quite a bit of caramel in it. But other than that, it's a little citrusy. Some nice toasted malts in there. Oh, this is going to be a good one. And I tell you what, there's a little bit of hint of chocolate in here as well. So let's thank the brewers there at Alewerks in Williamsburg, Virginia for all the hard work they did to brew this batch of beer. And we'll thank you at home for watching. Cheers. Generally speaking, and I'm very generally speaking, I don't care much for brown ales, but this is an exceptional brown ale. Nice, lovely roasted malts in here. Lovely roasted malt. Just a hint of chocolate. Not overboard, just a hint. It's out there in left field. This is pretty good. This is pretty good. But again, I'm not a big fan of brown ales. And this right here, it's going to be a one and done for me. It's not something that I would go to. It's not a beer I would classify as a go-to beer on a Saturday afternoon. Nonetheless, it is very refreshing indeed. And I don't know what types of hops or malts are in here. I didn't do any research online, but I got all my information off the label here. Again, this is from Alewerks out of Williamsburg, Virginia. I would describe this as a medium-bodied ale. Very refreshing indeed. If you like roasted malts with a floral aroma in it, no doubt about that. A little bit of citrus here and there, a little bit of chocolate here and there. You'd love this beer. I would classify this as a digestive. That is a beer to have after your dinner. No doubt about it, especially with a steak dinner. Oh, yeah, this would be a very good accompaniment to a steak dinner afterwards. No doubt about it. And that aroma is just fabulous. Wow. I've had quite a few beers from Alewerks. I only had one beer from them that was iffy, and I think it was past date. I don't know, because I couldn't find a date on that bottle either. But generally speaking, Alewerks makes a pretty decent beer. So I'm going to wind it up here, and I'm going to definitely suggest that you try this beer from Alewerks, because life is short. Let's be happy, my friends. Drink great craft beer. Okay, everyone. As promised, Dr. Dave's going to tell you where he buys his beers and where you can buy them also. First on the list is rivalrybrews.com. Now, don't worry, I'm going to put the links in the description box for you. Rivalry Brews is a relatively new mail order place. It's based right here in Ohio in Medina, and they are fantastic. I tell you what, when they first started, I got free shipping on all the beers. Now, I think they charge me $2. $2 for 12 beers, that's fantastic. Now, as far as I know, they ship to the lower 48, but you might want to check the website on that. I can't be 100% sure. But the shipping is fast. The turnaround is fast, and if anything's wrong, they will fix it right away. I only had one issue with them, and they refunded half my purchase order, which I thought was more than fair. More than fair. So anyway, by the way, disclaimer, I don't get any money on any of this. I'm not affiliated with any of these beer companies. They don't know I'm doing this. I'm just telling you where to buy the beer. Now, one day I may be affiliated, and if I am at that point, I'll certainly let you know. So Rivalry Brews, located right here in Ohio, they specialize in Ohio beers, beers from Pennsylvania and Indiana. So if you want some good Ohio craft beer, that's a good place to start. The second one on my list, oh, I love this place. It's called Halftime Beer. Halftime Beer has two locations in New York State, Poughkeepsie, and I believe it's pronounced Mamaroneck. Mamaroneck. Yeah, don't quote me on that pronunciation. I tried my best. Yeah, anyway. They have more beer online than you could possibly look at in a day. I'm telling you, they have beer everywhere on that website. And all you have to do is go on there, make your selection, and have it shipped. Now, they do have gift boxes, which come with a really nice cooler. Yeah, and you can't beat it. It's $5 shipping on those special orders. Now, on the other beers, the shipping can get a little bit pricey, but I've never had an order for more than $20 shipping, which I think is really good for 12 bottles of beer. Now, if you get cans, it's less cost because it weighs less, and that's what costs the money is the weight and the size of the box. So, yeah, check them out. Now, I belong to two of their what's known as Beer of the Month Club. I'm in their German Beer of the Month Club, so I get 12 bottles from six different breweries, two of each, once a month, and there's a lot of beers in there that I've never heard of from Germany. I thought I had them all, not even close. And then I have the Around the World Beer Club, which is exactly what it sounds like. It's beers from all over the world. So far, I only got one beer that I didn't really like. You know, it happens. It happens. And, you know, you take your chances on that. But I got some beer from South Korea, of all places, South Korea. I thought it was really, really good. Now, last on the list, but not least, and I didn't put these in any particular order, it's the Best Damn Beer Shop. Now, they're out of San Diego. And they have a killer selection, I'm telling you. Matter of fact, talking about all this beer, I'm going to have one here. That's just a regular run-of-the-mill Pilsner, German style, but it hits the spot on a day like this. Anyway, Best Damn Beer Shop.
Woo. Now, their shipping, they require you to choose in lots of six. So you can get 6, 12, 18, 24 is the maximum. And their shipping is reasonable, considering I'm on the East Coast and they're on the West Coast. Yeah, the shipping is generally about $19 for a 12-bottle selection, which I don't think is a lot. $19? No, I don't think that's a lot. Now, the more beer you buy, the less money it's going to cost. That's just a fact of economics. So if you want to buy six beers, it's going to cost more to ship it than the 12. Hey, I don't make the rules, man. Just buy more beer. You save more money on shipping. What can I tell you? Yeah, but they're a great place. And so all three of those places, Rivalry Brews for Ohio beers. And then you have the Halftime Beverage, which is in New York. They have a selection on everything. And same thing with Best Damn Beer Shop. Now, if you want some West Coast beers that you can't find in your town, that's the place to buy them at. Last but not least, people always ask me, what is that on your beer glass? Well, I bought it at Amazon, Amazon.com. It's called a vacuum vin. And if I'm not mistaken, it's from Sweden, if I'm not mistaken. And the inside of it is lined with special material. So what you do is you put this in the freezer, you let it sit overnight, and then you put your beverage in here. And it will maintain that beverage at around 38 degrees, which is really cold for a beer. But I like my Pilsners cold. Now, if you already have a beer that warmed up, put it in here and it'll bring it to the proper temperature, no doubt. And I said last, but I was mistaken. This is the last thing I want to talk about. Dr. Dave's beer glasses. Now, I did sell these a number of years ago when I had my other beer channel. And, this is a new design, though. This is a different design. Now, I could sell these if there's enough interest in them, but I have to order them about 144 at a time. So I don't want to order them unless there's some real interest in them. Now, it's difficult to see on here, but it says Dr. Dave's Cheap Ass Beer Reviews. Yeah, it's not really going to come out that well there on the camera, but I would sell these at cost. Now, I'm not trying to make any money on them. I think it cost me $14.98 to have those made. So I would sell them at the same price. Now, I don't know if the price could have gone up because I did buy those a few years back. So, but I would sell them at cost if anybody's interested. But like I said, I don't get any money off these links. There's no affiliate links here. I'm not making any money. I just wanted to let everybody know where I buy my beer so you could buy it too. Oh, and you know, I almost forgot. The Amazing Clubs Beer of the Month Club. Amazing Clubs. I'll put all the links in the description box. Knock yourself out. Hey, thanks for watching, okay? And Dr. Dave says cheers to that.